Hey everyone, there's always the latest craze in the tech industry that gets investors' dollars flowing. A few years ago, it was Bitcoin and blockchain.
Blockchain.
Now, the buzzword is AI.
We need more AI.
You might already know that NVIDIA is doing really well in the AI space, to the point that gaming is now only a minor priority for NVIDIA. But what about AMD? Well, they are eager to compete with NVIDIA, so they've recently been advertising the AMD AI Chatbot a lot. But is this anything special, or is it just marketing? Well, if you look at one of AMD's AI blog posts about how to run a local AI chatbot on your Ryzen AI PC, lots of buzzwords there, you'll see that it mentions LM Studio. But here's the thing, that's not an AMD-specific project. LM Studio is just a neat way of running a range of different large language models, basically AI chatbots, on your Mac, Windows, or Linux PC. If you look at the system requirements at the bottom, they are wide open. Both NVIDIA and AMD graphics cards are supported, and any CPU that supports AVX2 can run LM Studio. That would all suggest that anyone can run AMD's AI chatbot, right? Or is there some special AI that AMD are doing here that I've overlooked so far? Well, firstly, it's worth pointing out that AMD are working on improving the drivers for both their CPUs and GPUs so that they have more AI support. They're also keen to do deep tech dives on their blog that discusses how you can quantize and run some AI models from scratch, which is pretty cool. So they are getting more serious about AI support. What this means is that 1 year ago, we might have struggled to run local AI chatbots on our PCs, and now we can, so that's pretty cool. We basically just need to follow the instructions to do this. Download LM Studio or the preview release if you have a 7000 series GPU. I downloaded the standard LM Studio, but as I discussed later on, I can still use my GPU to power the AI chatbot. It's just that since I have a 6000 series of GPU, I can't take full advantage of some of the extra AMD AI support. Once the program is downloaded, you can search for a specific AI model. Either of the two that they recommended should work fine for basic demo purposes. So I went with Llama and I downloaded it. You'll notice that LM Studio tells you what your RAM and VRAM capacity is, and that the models will actually show whether the models will run entirely in your graphics card's VRAM or not, assuming the GPU supports running AI models, of course. That's good to know because being able to load the entire model into RAM or VRAM will make things run a lot faster. While AMD recommends the Q4 model, choosing the highest number of quants that actually run smoothly on your hardware is probably best, because you'll end up with a more powerful AI model. The model will be quite a few gigabytes in size, so plan ahead if you have a slower internet connection. Once it's downloaded, click the chat tab on the left-hand sidebar and select the particular model that you want to use. Before chatting, select GPU offload, if this option is enabled to you, because this will use your graphics card to speed up all the processing of the chatbot. You can then start chatting. You will probably notice a small delay before you get each result. That's normal enough for AI chatbots though. Yes, ChatGPT and Claude are a bit quicker, but this runs entirely locally, so it will be a bit slower. You can still see the results come back fairly quickly though, and they are pretty decent results. I asked it to generate a super awesome poem, which it did, and then I asked it to generate a very simple Python script, which it also did, and it ran through fine. So that's pretty cool. And it's actually amazing to me how far AI has come in just the last 1 or 2 years. Being able to run a half-decent chatbot entirely on our own local consumer-level hardware is pretty sweet. However, it's still worth pointing out that these local chatbots are nowhere near as powerful as the chatbots provided by OpenAI and others, which I guess kind of makes sense, of course, because they spend hundreds of millions of dollars on AI supercomputers, after all. But it is still cool that we can run a chatbot locally that costs us no money at all, and doesn't send all our data off to the cloud somewhere. My light testing of AMD's AI chatbot, and remember this is not really AMD specific, is the local chatbot can work fairly well for you, especially for simple coding help. So this could be a decent stopgap measure if you've exhausted all of your usage limits on ChatGPT or Claude, for example. Having said all that, it's worth pointing out that some users prefer COBOL for running AI models. It is more technical and more difficult to set up, but it's also more powerful. And this also runs fine on supported AMD hardware. So is AMD's AI chatbot some groundbreaking new development that will change AI forever and make Lisa Su the world's richest person? Well, no. No, it won't. NVIDIA is still way ahead here, to be honest. Chat with RTX is a more powerful chatbot, and NVIDIA's graphics cards runs AI models better than AMD's cards will, in general, due to NVIDIA's Tensor cores, which are pretty amazing and powerful, to be honest. I'd say that if you were looking to build a brand new PC and one of your main priorities was running local LLM models, you should go with an NVIDIA GPU and check out Chat with RTX, or even run through the AMD chatbot guide, because that will run fine with NVIDIA hardware too. AMD are running behind the AI curve here, to be honest. But It's still good that AMD are improving hardware support for AI models, and if you have an all-AMD build, like I do, then at least we can now run local chatbots through LLM Studio with minimal hassle, and that's pretty cool. And that wraps up today's short video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.